Welcome to the best budget car in South Africa. There's a reason why Suzuki is the third best-selling car brand in the country. They sell the best budget cars out there. Today we are checking out this Suzuki Baleno. We will talk about its exterior, interior, and as part of the tradition, we will discuss its cost of ownership. You're watching Cars 24, your ultimate car buying guide. This car doesn't need any introduction really. It's literally the best car you can buy for less than 300,000. It's above its competitors in terms of standard features, fuel economy, and the cost of running it on a man-to-man basis. Because of the Suzuki Toyota alliance, this Baleno shares most, if not all of its core features with the Toyota Starlet. The Starlet is more expensive than the Baleno, has less warranty and service plan compared to this Baleno. But Toyota is still selling more Starlets than Suzuki is selling its Balenos. For an example, in February 2024, Toyota sold 1,481 units of the Toyota Starlet, while Suzuki managed to sell 585 units of the Baleno. This is no surprise because we as South Africans are very brand conscious, and Toyota is a bigger brand than Suzuki, even though Suzuki are really expanding their footprint in our car market. There are two derivatives of the Baleno. There's a base model GL and the more spec'd GLX. This is the GL model, and it's easy to differentiate it from the GLX. The GL comes with halogen projector headlamps with front fog lights, while the GLX comes with LED projector headlamps and LED daytime running lights. On the side, the GL comes with body colored door handles, while in the GLX, they are chrome. The GL has these 15-inch steel wheels with full wheel cover. The GLX comes with 16-inch alloy wheels. The Baleno has 6 different colors, and silver is arguably the best of the 6, but you cannot go wrong with the white color. The other colors are very difficult to maintain. Let's move on to the interior. By budget car standards, this is a very good interior. I like the layout of this dashboard with its two-tone effect. This dashboard is made of hard plastic materials, but this doesn't concern me because I hardly touch the dashboard to check its quality, and it's a budget car at the end of the day. The areas you are always in contact with has soft touch materials, like here on the door and the center armrest. As part of the standard features in the GLX, you get this flat bottom multifunction steering wheel with your cruise control and volume controls in it. You get analog dials. The middle dial is the only one that is digital, and it shows your fuel range, fuel consumption, and mileage. You get this 7-inch display screen, which supports Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, and both of them are wireless. You have an automatic air conditioner. Down here, you have an area for a mobile phone. You have a USB port and a 12-volt socket. The two cup holders are in front of your gear knob, which is nice because if you have cups in them, they doesn't interfere with you when you're changing gears. You have a manual handbrake and an armrest that is retractable, as you can see. The glove box in the Baleno is average in terms of size. All these things I just mentioned, they come as standard in the base model GL, and there's more at the back. Space is surprisingly good. There's more than enough knee room and leg room. Headroom is not bad considering the sloping roof line. And even the middle seat is not bad at all. You have this pocket area, which you can use to store your personal items, avoiding any damage to them. You have two rear air vents and two USB ports at the back for your back passengers. And if you have a kid, there are two pairs of ISOFIX anchor points for your child seat. Now let's move on to the boot. The capacity is measured to be around 318 liters, which is more than enough for two couples living in urban areas. And underneath your fourth floor, you get a biscuit spare wheel in case of an emergency. So in summary, the Baleno is a very good budget car with very good standard features for a budget car, and it doesn't disappoint as well in terms of practicality. Under the hood of this Baleno is a tried and tested 1.5-liter natural aspirated engine. that produces 77 kilowatts and 138 newton meters of torque. This engine can be mated to a 4-speed auto or a 5-speed manual. This GL has a manual gearbox and is very lovely. The Baleno is very smooth on the road. You do get a bit of wind noise and tire noise when you're cruising at highway speed, but that shouldn't be a problem because you have 4 speakers with Bluetooth connectivity and App Connect. The seats are very comfortable, but they don't come with height adjustability. Fuel wise, Suzuki claims an average fuel consumption rate of 5.4 liters per 100 kilometers, and I'm averaging around 5.6 and 5.7 liters per 100 kilometers, which is not far off from the claimed figure, and I'm achieving this without even trying. Suzuki offers the Baleno with the 5-year or 200,000 km warranty and the 4-year or 60,000 km service plan. I made a video last year after Suzuki released the Fronx about which car I think is better to buy between the Baleno GLX and the Fronx GL. I still feel the Baleno GLX has nice features compared to this GL, but I would rather spend 300,000 on the Fronx GL than spending the same amount on the Baleno GLX. The Baleno GL is a different story. I think for its price, it's really worth it. If you decide to buy the GL manual, which is priced at 247,900, and you get a contract offer for 72 months at an interest rate of 11.75% with no Baleno deposit, expect to pay around 4,906 rand for your monthly installment. A full tank for the Baleno is around 850 rand, and you can expect to pay around 1,500 for a comprehensive insurance cover. Adding all this takes your monthly cost of ownership for the Baleno GL to around 7,256 rand per month. This marks the end of this review. If you enjoyed it, please make sure you give it a like and share with your friends and family. We'll meet again on our next video. Until next time. Peace.